Hi, Robbie Robinson here with Jeff Taylor. We're to do a special show today on the OSS races on Sunday, plus Family Day. And I'd just like to give a brief history on the OSS program. The OSS program was started in 1974 to promote harness racing and the breeding industry in Ontario. There's been a number of standouts in the last 49 years. When they started the industry, I can remember growing up in Kingston when the OSS would come through town. We had trotters like Shawlin Bell and Shawlin Don, which were dominant horses that came through the area, and it was a real good show when the OSS come to town. Anyways, we've had a lot of nice horses come out of the Ottawa area. Back in 1976, Norman Jones had a trotter called RB Jet who dominated the Ontario Sire Stakes at 2 and 3. He was owned by a lady named Ray Bodie, who's the mother of a good friend of mine, Rick Bodie, the Highway Cowboy. But RB Jet went on to be a free-for-all trotter in Blue Bonnets and the OJC, and I believe he represented Canada 2 times in the International Trot. We've also had other trainers in this area, like Mark Stacey, who had horses like Majestic Sun, were dominant horses. And the program really upped the game for Ontario, made us a world-class place to race with horses like recently Bulldog Hanover, Some Beach Somewhere, and horses like Good Times, Glory's Comet, and we've seen some real standouts here, like the North America Cup winner Apache's Fame set a track record when he came here. The other trotter that Bud Fritz had that win 31 in a row, the name is mistaking me right now, but we've seen a lot of good horses come out of the program, and I think that we got a good shot, if the weather's good, to see a nice sub 49 mile here in the gold division with the quality of animals in there. I think we're gonna have a real nice show on Sunday night. And we'll start off, I guess we're gonna talk about the fourth race. What do you think, Jeff?
For me, it's a toss up between the 6 and the 7. It is a tough field, but what I like about the 7 Ike's Dream is he's got great gate speed. He's got really good last quarters, and aside from his last couple of starts, he's pretty consistent. I think he is gonna make front, and I think he can dictate his own fractions after that. I do think this horse will adjust to the 5/8 pretty good. He shows getting over Clinton on a good mile back on OSS on July 9th, and I think he gets top bid for me. I think the 6 will be close, and like I say, it could go either way between the two of them, but I think I like the 7 on top. I like Dream with Bob McClure. I like Louis-Philippe Waugh on the 6, sounds good, and I think you got to keep the 3 horse in there, wise thinking. I know he's winless this year, but I'm never going to discredit Bob McIntosh's horses. He's going to come here with his horses ready. And if you've watched Trevor Henry lately, this guy's a money driver, and I think Trevor's going to have him in the hunt, and I wouldn't leave him out of your top 4 for sure.
Yeah, I've got to totally agree with you on that one. I like Ike's Dream. 6 sounds good, is owned by local people. They're just south of the border, Mike and Sam Sergi, big supporters of Rideau Carlton Raceway. And we also have 2 other horses in here. Bet's Show Off, trained by Ronnie McDonald and is owned by Jermaine Brazo, who just lives down the road from here, has a farm here. And All Bets on Tex, trained by local trainer Mike Armstrong.
So we're in agreement on the first stake for sure.
I think we'll do the second grassroot. We'll leave the gold to last.
Sure.
The 8th race, we got a couple local horses in there, Bedenberg and LaBarbe. They've unfortunately drew the outside positions. But to me, this race looks like 1 and 2 are the 2 tough horses in here. They come off a good form. Maybe the 4, another Bob McIntosh horse to round out the try. But they look alone to me. I don't know. What do you think?
Well, it's the luck of the draw wasn't very good to the local guys. They'd really have to, you know, step up, and I mean, you never know what's going to happen. But I'm kind of going between the one and the two, joker on Jack and leave it to Leo. Both of them show good gate speed. I think joker on Jack is only getting better. He seems to have kind of turned the tide a little bit back since July 8th. He's on Lasix now. His last quarter show, he's improved on it. I think he's just hitting his stride right now. And I mean, it could go either way. The two's probably going to have the trip on his back. Sorry, the one is going to have the trip on his back. But I mean, Jody's a good, good driver too. He's good on the front end. He does well at Rito. And I'm going to throw the four and the five in there as well. Another McIntosh horse, which I mean, it'd be no surprise if he upset my two top picks, but I'm going to go with the one and the two for sure. And we'll throw the four and five in there as well.
Yeah. And the five, Louis Philippe, he also does well here. He knows the track well, so that could be a factor too. Race 10, I see like four horses that really could be winners in here. Sobel Ace with Bob McClure, Ace of Aces, Win'em Back, and Koopaloop. Any one of those horses could step up to win. The interesting horse in there is Ace of Aces. He raced in the NA Cup of Limbs and the Consolation. But when I was growing up in Kingston, there was a top horse there named Ace of Aces. Chris Storms used to race him and other trainers. And I don't know whether this horse was named that or Mark Stacey's named him that. But that to me is pretty cool because I remember that horse well. And we got a local colt in there, yours. What do you think about your chances?
It's a tough group, and I think the grassroots gets tougher every year. It seems like they're more closer to golds every year. And the one thing about my colt is I used Stefan on him tonight, and you know, early in the year he wasn't the easiest horse to drive. He was a little bit hot. He's matured a lot. He's obviously going to need the trip. One thing about him is he'll give it everything he's got. He's probably the hardest trying horse I've ever owned. And I mean, I trust Stefan with him. I mean, I think he's underrated as a driver, especially on a young horse. And I know he'll give him the best trip he can. The trip's going to have to work out, but I know he'll give it his best shot for sure.
Yeah, I have to agree with you on the part about the golds are so close to the grassroots. As I raced a colt last year and the year before at 2 and 3, and he was so close to being a gold horse. He would come home 26 every week, but you know, he might have been seventh or eighth best, and it just didn't make sense to win the golds, because if you're seventh or eighth best and there's only one division, you're not getting any money. So I see a lot of these horses that look like they probably should be gold horses, but they're going to make more money in the grassroots.
And you can't really discount the horses that are at long odds in the morning line too. Like, these are also nice colts, and they're all going to round into really nice racehorses. It's just, it's a tough go in the stakes, and like we said, the gap between the gold and the grassroots seems to be shrinking every year. But you got to take your shot, and no better place than home.
Yeah, I always say, morning odds is just one person's opinion.
Exactly.
On to the sixth race, the OSS Gold. We got Stockade Sealster, who was the two-year-old pacing colt of the year in Canada and the U.S. last year, even though he never stepped foot in the United States. That's how highly thought of if he was. And the 7, Midnight Nation, the last two sire stakes has played Giant Killer, and again, he's 8-1 morning line, draw the 7 hole. That's unfortunate. But that could play into it being a very quick pace and a quick race. You know Jody's going to be moving forward no matter what. We got probably four other colts in here that, you know, are legitimate horses, with Max Delight, shows 49 miles. Better Be Bold shows 49. Even the three horse, he shows 49. The four, he shows 49. He was a race in the North America Cup. Write Me a Rose, another horse that raced in the NA Cup, Elims and Consolation. Now, I talked to Rob Fellows about this horse the other day because he was going to come, and he said if the driver drives him to win, he might finish fourth or fifth, but if they drive him just to drive to get a check, then he has a shot at winning. But this is a real tough field, and with the 7 and 8 drawing outside like that, I don't know, anything could happen. This is really shaping up to be maybe one of the best races we've ever seen here at Rideau Carlton.
Well, the closer you look at it, like, it's rare that you could say at Rideau that you see colts with miles and 49 on their lines and I'm leaving them out of the ticket.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's how deep this field is. I'm leaning towards the 7, to be quite honest. I do think Jody is going to cut this mile. His gate speed, you can't deny it. I mean, like you say, he was 2-year-old of the year last year. I think he's just as good this year. I think it's tougher for him because I think everybody else has just gotten better, which is, you know, what you aim for. But Midnight Nation, I think he's such a threat stalking off the pace. Like, he does show that he can leave in 27 seconds from the outside, but I don't think he has to. I think he can just bide his time. And again, I mentioned earlier, Trevor Henry, like, when the money's up, like, this guy can drive. Like, if you look, his 2 wins in his last 6 starts are both gold races for sire stakes. And if you look at the line closely, he's come from off the pace. And, I mean, when you're coming quarters in 25 and 4 and you're making up 7.5 lengths in the last 3 quarters or the last quarter mile, you know, you're smoking along. But I'm going to go with the 7. I mean, it could be the 8 as well, but I'm going to go 7-8. Another McIntosh horse, I like his moment, is here. He shows 3 miles in a row, sub 50. Closes like a freight train every week. He's got James McDonald. I mean, if there was an upset in here, I know he's 2-1 on the morning line. I do think it's going to be between the 7 and the 8, but if there was an upset, I would call the 4 moment is here. And I like the 1 horse off the rail. He hasn't drawn the greatest lately, but he seems to be always close, pretty consistent. But my top pick, I think, is the 7, Midnight Nation, with Trevor Henry. I'm going to put Jody 2nd. I'm going to play James for 3rd, and I'll throw Max Delight, one of Sean Stacy's, in for 4th.
Yeah, I like the 2 Stacy horses. I think there's going to be an upset just because the action's going to be hot and heavy. They're not going to file in single file in this race. Somebody's going to get parked, I would believe. But I think there will be an upset. I like the 2 Stacy horses for an upset in here. That's who I think could upset, but who knows?
Should be a great race.
It's all up in the air. Yeah, I think we're going to see a history record mile here for 3-year-old pacing colts in the Glamour division.
I agree.
Geez, that's very rarely we both agree on everything.
pretty good show, if you ask me. All right, good luck with all your picks.
Good luck, and have a great time Sunday at Rideau Carlton Raceway on Family Day and the Clamor Boys, 3-year-old pacing colts.
Aneto from 2nd, Rhythm in Motion 3rd, Denali, Sealster on the outside, Night Watchman needs to do more, as does Examiner Hanover. There's an 1/8 of a mile to go. Beaumont Hanover has been sent on a gate-to-wire mission by Jameson and looks strong coming for the payoff. Beaumont Hanover wins this one with ridiculous ease. Wins it by a solid 3 over Aneto, finishing 3rd, Denali Sealster, in a track record equaling 150-2.
Back on the inside, and Write Me a Rose went up right on town. The shirt's running home. Moment is Here is Santana. Ahead of her moment is here. It's going to win the OSS Gold. Santana has her second. And then Butch Lord at third.
Yeah, it's been a terrific run. You know, I'm truly blessed to get so many great horses to drive, work with so many great trainers, owners, grooms, you know. It's fun coming to the track and just seeing your name beside great animals like this. I can't explain how fun it is.